Tucker Carlson refused to say if he would endorse Donald Trump. Here it is.
Who do you plan to support, Donald Trump or Ron DeSantis?
Well, who am I going to support? Well, Joshua, as you've noticed, my endorsement means a lot to American voters. Donald Trump completely changed my view of everything. Donald Trump is why I left Washington. And he did it in a really simple way by asking questions that no one around him could answer. He showed up and said things like, why don't we have a border? Shut up! Shut up, racist! Or my personal favorite, he's like, what's the point of NATO? But I wouldn't have known any of that until Trump showed up and started asking these kind of like autistic simple questions, like, why are we doing it that way? Shut up, racist! And it's exposed the whole thing, and I'm so grateful to have seen that. And I should also add, since why not, I actually love Donald Trump as a guy. I think he's one of the funniest people I've ever talked to in my life. I think he's got this unbelievable life force to him. But talking to Trump is one of the great joys, one of the great animal joys of life, because he exudes this kind of animal joy. And to the truth, Trump is like totally charming and engaging and fun and interesting. And the last thing I'll say about Trump that I really love is that his insights into people, which are always expressed in this, because I use words for a living, so I notice how people express things. Trump expresses himself in this way that's like completely original.
Are you endorsing a man or not? Now, he later said he's not endorsing anybody. He told some weird story about Mike Tyson. It was all over the place. So no, he's not going to endorse Donald Trump. This is another layer of the dysfunction that Trump brought and the dysfunction he's now receiving from the party. So Tucker Carlson is a no-Trumper now. He could have just answered the question, decided to give a bunch of stories afterwards and before. During this event, it was a Turning Point USA event, Charlie Kirk's organization. But Tucker Carlson was very complimentary of his new bromance, and that's Governor Ron DeSantis. And he said, and I quote, I spent a lot of time in Florida, Carlson said, and I think Ron DeSantis has done like an unbelievable job. All right, there it is. I highlight that to show at least one reality of Donald Trump. Many people who have always been supportive, they're now being at least critical or semi-critical, including Steve Bannon, including Mike Pence and others. Ben, thoughts here?
Tucker Carlson is a very, very low IQ individual. Right. He is a very strange, deranged person who laughs like some kind of weird non-human animal, like a gerbil or something. That's the way he laughs every time. He's insane. And these guys belie every time that they speak their priorities. They do not care about morality. They do not care about policy. They do not care about how somebody affects the nation they are hoping to lead yet again. He says he's fun and charming and the funniest guy he's ever talked to. And he has an animal joy that gives him an animal joy. I mean, the homoerotic bromance between the two of these. Take it outside, get a room, the two of you. But what's that got to do with somebody's policies? I have an animal joy. And lastly, Tucker Carlson can never appear in life without wearing some form of khakis. Always khaki pants, just showing he came off of a boat, a racist boat floating in some weird white island of privilege somewhere, unrelatable to any human being with a heart. What a disgusting person. Animal joy, and he's so funny. Go. See him at a comedy club.
And he likes his life force. Okay.
Loves his animal joy life force.
Right. Weird. All right.